Christ is risen. I'm here in the altar of Holy Ghost Church, and I just wanted to give you a quick overview of the things that we'll be celebrating in the church over the next month. And as you know, over this past week, on Holy Friday, we remembered Jesus being crucified. This is a terrible scene, and it looks very beautiful, but it is a terrible scene because it shows Jesus being put to death on a cross, crucified, with nails put in his feet and his hands. A spear was put in his side, and just about everybody around him left him because they were afraid. So they went into hiding, except for Mary, his mother, and his disciple John, who was the youngest disciple around Jesus. But everybody else left because they were afraid. And after he was buried, some of the women, and it was the women, who went to the tomb, to the grave, to go see if they could be at Jesus' tomb and bring sweet-smelling spices to anoint his body. And I'll show you a couple other icons about this, about the stories that we're looking at. Here are the women. They came to the tomb, and they found it empty. An angel was there and said, "He is not here. Jesus is risen." The women were shocked, and they went back to tell the men, but the men didn't believe them. And then Jesus himself appeared to the men and wondered why it was that they hadn't believed the women. And the disciples were, of course, amazed to see Jesus alive. But one of the disciples wasn't there, and that was Thomas. Thomas was only there 8 days later because Thomas had said, "I'm not going to believe either. If I don't see him with my own eyes, if I don't put my finger in his side or in the print of the nails, I won't believe." Well, 8 days later, and this is St. Thomas Sunday, Thomas was there with the rest of the disciples. And at that point, he believed. And there you see Thomas putting his finger into the side of Jesus, Jesus showing that it really is him, that he is in a completely different form. He can go through walls. It's a different kind of human being than we are now, but they could still recognize him, and they could recognize all the marks of the crucifixion that were on him. Well, Jesus spent 40 days with the disciples. The risen Jesus spent 40 days with the disciples, teaching them about his message, what it was he wanted to share with the world, which we call the gospel message. And 40 days later, after his resurrection, we come to the feast of the Ascension. And here you see Jesus ascending, being lifted up into heaven, with his disciples looking on, and Mary in the middle looking on as well, and angels there. That's the feast of the Ascension, 40 days after Easter. And after that, we have the feast of Pentecost. Jesus told his disciples to wait in Jerusalem until they would be clothed with power from on high, meaning that they would be clothed, they would have the descent of the Holy Spirit upon them. So 50 days after Easter, you have the descent of the Holy Spirit. And here you see, again, Mary in the middle and the disciples around, and they have tongues of fire. You can see in this beautiful stained glass, tongues of fire coming down over their heads. I'll have a lot more to say about that in days to come. The other beautiful stained glass in the altar is this icon, the stained glass icon of the resurrection. No one ever saw Jesus himself at that very moment when he rose again from the dead, but this is an icon of the resurrection. It's a kind of symbolic representation of Jesus rising from the dead, and you have two angels on the sides, but Jesus in the middle in the resurrection. So you have, first of all, in the altar, you have the icon of the crucifixion. And after the crucifixion, his death, he's buried, he rises again from the dead. And his promise to everyone after his resurrection from the dead is that in a few days' time, it actually turned out to be 50 days' time, they would all receive the Holy Spirit. And that would put a very special, it would give them a very special relationship then with God. They would understand, they'd receive God's own Spirit, the same Spirit that Jesus himself had received. Well, as I said, I'll have a lot more to say in days to come. But right now, that's the full story in very brief form of these days that we have just celebrated and will celebrate over the next
few weeks. Christ is risen.
He